Yes, let's get started. First of all, you're going to decide where you want your part to be. In this case, I want it to be on the left side of my head, so I'm going to move the closure to the left side. That's the closure. It is placed a little bit off to the left. It's not in the middle anymore. Secure the wig to the mannequin head using some pins, one side, the other side, and then just make sure you do the back as well, just to ensure some security. I'm going to show you how to use these flexi rods. You just bend them and they stay in place. Now, some people have trouble with that because they fall off. I'm going to go step by step and show you exactly how to get it done so that it stays. Partition about 2 inches of hair, comb it through, and place the hair on the flexi rod, on one end of the flexi rod, just like that, and then take it around, go in circles, and that little tip, we're gonna have to make that disappear because we can't let it hang. So wrap it around and then start rolling the rod down the shaft of the hair. See how secure that is? That's what we're trying to achieve. When you have that security, then go ahead and roll it, occupying the rest of the flexi rod in that direction. And once you roll away from you, you bend towards you. Just remember, it's always opposite. This style is so easy. The only things you need are the flexi rods and water in a spray bottle. That's it. So I'm going to do more demonstrations. In fact, I'm going to do several. It's the exact same steps. Place the flexi rod on top of the hair and take the tip of the hair in circles around the flexi rod on the end of the flexi rod. And when you achieve that security, start rolling, making sure that tip is buried in there. You see that? It's pretty secure and the tip is not visible anymore. So continue to roll all the way down the flexi rod. And when you get to the end, you bend in the opposite direction in which you rolled. This style is so easy because the only thing you actually need is water and some flexi rods. Well, you need some sunshine in order for it to dry, but in the absence of sunshine, for example, if it's winter, you can always dry this indoors. You can use a hooded dryer, but if you're trying to lengthen the life of your extensions, you may want to avoid all that heat, so you really don't need a hooded dryer. Now, in the winter, you can place the wig above the air vents that pump the hot air into the house during the winter, and it still takes a couple of days to dry in that manner, but it does shorten the drying time a lot. Ideally, I would recommend you put the wig in direct sunlight. In direct sunlight, it's really going to dry a lot faster than any of the other methods I mentioned. And it is really important to invest in good quality hair extensions. These hair extensions are from Hair Lumiere. This wig is quite old. This is one of my oldest wigs. It is about 3 years old. See how good it still looks? That's why it's really important to invest in the hair you buy. It is worth it when you buy good hair. If you're interested in buying these hair extensions, just send me a message on my social media and we can have that arranged. I'm still working on a website for now. You got that fire, like a sweet melody. When we get to the baby hairs, this is how it's done. You have to saturate it with a large amount of water so that it sticks to the mannequin head just like that. You need them laying as flat as we possibly can. We're going to roll this one just like we did the others, but at the end of it, we're going to position it in such a way that it lays on top of the baby hair just like that and holds it in place. When you're putting curls in hair, always make sure that you form the curls going in a direction away from the face. This style is really good because there is no heat involved, and when there is no heat, it just makes your hair extensions last longer. This style is also awesome in case you do not have reliable electricity to use a hot tool to put these curls. This requires no heat. All you need is sunlight. If it is winter where you are, you can place it over the air vents right there in the winter. It takes about a week. It takes a really long time to get dry. See, my flexi rods are so assorted. There are so many different sizes, but I think they are at least a 3/4 inch and below. So I go ahead and take them off. It's been a few days and the hair is totally dry. Make sure it is completely dry. Now you can see the baby hairs, they came out beautifully, and the curls are really tight at this point. I do not like my curls too tight. I like them kind of loose. I like them to fall. If you style it this way, it's going to look like one big afro. So I like to keep the curls to get old, to drop. So I put the wig out on a sunny day in the wind, and when the wind blows through it, the curls become loose just like beachy waves. That is 20 inches of hair, just FYI. Strand of curls and split it in two. That's it. Just take one and split it. If you don't want to do the splitting method, you can do this other method that gives it more volume. Simply run your fingers through from the roots all the way to the ends. Now, there's no tangles because this is really good quality hair extensions. And like I said, it is 3 years old. It is quite old. So invest in your extensions to avoid those tangles. See how easily my fingers move through it? No tangles at all. And there's almost no shedding.